Bonjour à tous. The last few weeks have been hard in different ways for everyone. You're worried about your job or your business. You're concerned about your health or the health of an elderly parent. No matter what this has meant for you, I know you're looking for answers. Knowing where we are now and where we might be in the coming weeks and months is how we can all figure out our response. For you, that could be planning on how to make sure the kids keep learning even though they're at home. For our government, the numbers and data compiled by our experts are critical to understanding the scope of this pandemic and informing the decisions we make to keep you safe. And we've made sure you can access the most reliable, accurate information available to us at canada.ca/coronavirus. We're going to keep releasing up-to-date data on a daily basis and using it to inform our decisions. And we'll continue working with the provinces and territories on getting new information to have a complete national picture that we'll share with you. Regardless of the varying models or predictions, one thing is consistently clear. The measures that have been put in place by all orders of government, from closing schools to staying home, are saving lives. But this will only keep working if everyone continues to do their part. If everyone takes their duty to nurses and doctors, to the elderly and to the vulnerable, seriously. As seriously as if it were the life of their parent or their child on the line. Because it is. The cashier at the store is someone's brother. The paramedic saving lives is someone's wife. That's what's at stake here. The lives of the people we love, the lives of the people our neighbors love. So do your part. Wash your hands, stay 2 meters away from each other, and above all, stay home. Ça fait plusieurs semaines maintenant que nous restons à la maison. C'est ce qu'il faut faire, en plus de garder nos distances et se laver les mains. En fait, c'est à la maison que la plupart d'entre nous se sentent le plus en sécurité en ce moment. Mais imaginez si vous aviez plus peur de rester chez vous que d'affronter la pandémie. Malheureusement, c'est la réalité pour beaucoup trop de Canadiens. C'est le quotidien des femmes qui sont victimes de violences. Aucune mère ne devrait avoir à choisir entre garder ses enfants dans une maison où ils sont en danger ou les emmener dans un endroit où ils pourraient tomber malades. On a donc investi 40 millions de dollars dans les refuges pour femmes et les centres qui viennent en aide aux victimes d'agressions sexuelles. Et pour les femmes et les enfants autochtones qui fuient la violence, on a investi 10 millions de dollars dans les refuges d'urgence. Ces fonds aideront les refuges pour femmes à prendre toutes les mesures nécessaires pour protéger les gens non seulement contre la violence, mais aussi contre la COVID-19. Pour aider les sans-abri, on a augmenté de plus de 157 millions de dollars le financement destiné au programme Vers un chez-soi. Les responsables du programme pourront donc acheter des choses comme des autres lits ou louer des nouveaux locaux pour que les gens dorment pas trop près les uns des autres. On envoie de l'argent aux communautés qui en ont besoin, de Vancouver à Saskatoon, de Toronto à Halifax. C'est pas juste une question d'offrir aux gens un endroit sûr où aller pour échapper à la violence ou pour éviter de dormir dans la rue. Il faut protéger tous les membres de notre société contre la COVID-19, et ça inclut les plus vulnérables. No one should have to choose between being somewhere there unsafe and risking getting COVID-19. That's why we've invested $40 million for women's shelters and sexual assault centers across the country. And for Indigenous women and children fleeing violence, we're providing $10 million for emergency shelters. For other shelters, we've boosted funding for the Reaching Home program by over $157 million. This will help buy things like physical barriers or rent new space to keep people safe. The communities that need this funding have now been identified and money is getting to them. For people from Victoria to Hamilton and Regina to St. John's, help has arrived. I know we're asking a lot right now. To stay home, to not see friends, to close your business temporarily. It's not easy. I get that. But these sacrifices are necessary. The price of acting otherwise is just too steep. To those who are sick right now, or have family in hospital, in the ICU. To those who've lost a loved one or a friend. We're thinking of you. We're here for you. And you remind us of what's on the line. We all need to take physical distancing very seriously. Done right, these measures will save lives and bridge us slowly but surely back to normal. At the same time, we're working around the clock to get Canada the resources we need. In the next 48 hours, we will be receiving a shipment of millions of masks by a chartered cargo flight. We're also working with provinces to transport their medical supplies when possible. Items ordered by Quebec will be on this flight. Our government has also leased a warehouse in China to help collect and distribute these items as quickly as possible. And going forward, the flights we're chartering to get the materials here include Canadian companies Cargojet and Air Canada. I want to take a moment to thank everyone, whether you're working in a warehouse, flying the plane, or part of the ground crew, for your dedication. These are vital supplies for people on the front lines and are key to fighting the virus. People in our hospitals are saving lives every single day. They can't be worried about running out of the equipment that'll keep them or you safe. And for everyone else, to give our country the best shot possible, we're doing everything we can to support you while you do your part. So this weekend, stay at home. Protect your loved ones and our frontline workers. Save lives. I want to take a moment to talk to kids again today. Even at home, there's lots of stuff going on. There's lots of stuff to do. I'll be holding a video conference tomorrow with Dr. Tam to talk through some of your questions. I know a lot of you have sent them in, and I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Tomorrow, you'll also have a chance to ask someone who knows better than anyone else about staying inside, an astronaut. Canadian astronaut Jeremy Hansen will be live on YouTube tomorrow to talk with you. So ask your parents to help send in a question ahead of time. Aux enfants, je sais que vous avez beaucoup de questions. Alors demain, écoutez ma vidéoconférence avec la Dr. Tam où je répondrai à vos questions. Et n'oubliez pas que l'astronaute canadien Jeremy Hansen sera en direct sur YouTube demain aussi. Pour protéger votre salaire et l'économie, on a élaboré un plan à trois volets qui va nous permettre de protéger les emplois, soutenir les petites entreprises et aider ceux qui ont perdu leur chèque de paie. Pour protéger votre santé et la santé de tous nos travailleurs essentiels, on travaille avec plusieurs entreprises pour fabriquer et distribuer du matériel médical et de l'équipement de protection personnelle. On va vous aider à affronter la tempête. Mais on a besoin que vous fassiez votre part. Je sais que je peux compter sur vous. Cette fin de semaine, restez chez vous. Sauvez nos travailleurs de première ligne. Sauvez nos vies. Merci.